Our fifth out front story tonight, this, the cover of Time magazine. That's 26-year-old mom Jamie Lynn Grumet with her 3-year-old son. Now, the cover story looks at 20 years since Dr. William Sears wrote The Baby Book. It lays out his attachment parenting theory. Now, attachment parenting includes breastfeeding, sometimes into toddlerhood, sleeping with a baby in the mother's bed, baby wearing, which means literally attaching a baby to the mother. You may have seen people with slings, and not allowing an infant to cry. Out front tonight is Jamie Lynn Grumet. Her son, Aram, of course, was on the cover. And Time magazine, Jeffrey Kluger, is also with us as well, the editor of the story. Great to have both of you with us.
Thank you.
And Jamie, let me just start with you. I don't know, when you made the decision to do this, did you know you were going to be in the cover, or did all of a sudden you wake up and say, whoa?
No, I mean, Time contacted me, and it was basically going to be possibly just for the article heading and not for the cover story. So I didn't know basically until the day before. And I didn't know the photo until everybody else saw it for the first time, too. So I didn't know which one was going to be selected.
So are you happy? Not sure? Angry? How do you feel?
I know. I'm definitely, I understand why Time chose the photo that they did, but I have seen a lot of backlash in, you know, breastfeeding advocates saying it doesn't represent how real extended breastfeeding is mm-hmm. really perceived, and it's true. I mean, that's not how we breastfeed at home.
But is he really breastfeeding in the picture?
Yes, he's really breastfeeding in the picture, but, you know, I think they just wanted to try out some artistic poses and give kind of just a really literal and artistic view of extended breastfeeding, obviously to start, you know, to make it controversial and start a dialogue, which I think mm-hmm. they did.
I mean, you're an editor. You want controversy.
Right.
You got it.
We got controversy. But I think it's important to remember, as Jamie mentions, that the point of generating controversy is so that people will read the story mm-hmm. and so that people will talk about the story.
Yes.
Attachment parenting can be very controversial. It does have issues associated with it. There are parents who say, this is simply not what I am temperamentally equipped to do. It's not what my job will permit me to do. Does this somehow make me a deficient parent? Other parents who are committed to it say, this is exhausting. And a whole third group say, this is the greatest thing I ever could have imagined for my child. We want to present those sides. And the only way to get that into, to get people to do that, is get them to read the story, which was written by one of our writers, Kate Pickard, who did an exhaustive look into this and really got down into what the pros and cons of all of it are.
So, Jamie, what are your thoughts of attachment parenting? I mean, are you doing all parts of it? I mean, do you think it's fair to represent you that way?
I'm doing most of it, definitely. I mean, I think we do it to fit our lifestyle. And every parent is different. Every child is different. And I think that that's the most important thing, is that it should, my hope for doing this is to create the dialogue and perhaps, you know, take the stigma away from attachment parenting that, you know, is clearly mothers are feeling stressed from all of the attacks that they're getting from it. So that's what I'm hoping, is that this will create enough dialogue to maybe educate people on why this is biologically normal and not socially normal.
Now, it's interesting. There's been obviously incredible conversation on Twitter. Some have defended you. Deborah Guerrero said, all I have to say is a mother knows what's best, no problem with the cover at all, and supporting you. Paula Rick Bickford wrote this, though. When he is 15, ask him if he likes this picture.
I think that is a really, I mean, it's a great thing to talk about, you know, the repercussions of what this will do to my child when he's older. But I was breastfed by my mother until I was 6. She was a breastfeeding advocate and really public about it.
So it's part of your childhood. Do you remember it?
Yes, I do. And she had, I mean, public photos, never made it a dirty or secret act for me. And by doing that, and she stood up for what she believed in, caught a lot of flack. It was in the 80s, you know, when she was doing this. And I'm proud of her, and I'm doing it myself. So, you know, I think our family is, you know, out of all families, we can handle this, and we knew it was coming. So so I understand, and I appreciate the concern from other people, but our family is, you know, a little bit different than the average family, and we're going
very gracious in the way you address it. Which is a very important point to make.
May I add one thing to that? We have, of course, heard that issue as well, and we've seen it on our Facebook posts, and we've seen it on Twitter responses.
Right.
And my response is, how will it affect the child? Well, I don't know, and the people asking the question don't know.
That's right.
But there is no human in the world who knows that boy better than his mama. And
exactly.
She would not let mm-hmm. something bad happen to him. So my assumption is that Jamie would not have posed for this picture if she weren't confident that mm-hmm. there would be no negative repercussions.
Right.
No. I mean, we weren't doing it, you know, for publicity, because we knew the majority of it would be negative, and nobody really wants to put that on their family. We're really doing this to hopefully educate people on how this should be. I mean, other parenting practices should be accepted as well, but this one should be, and there's no reason that people should be saying the things that they are, and it's complete ignorance.
And how long, you talked about being breastfed until you were six. Is that
right.
what you plan to do with your children as well? Because I know you have two children, right?
Right, I do. My adopted son has basically weaned himself. Mm-hmm. It's a very natural process. My three-year-old has started the process of mm-hmm. self-weaning. I don't think we'll go past the fourth year with him. I self-weaned when I was six with my mother, and mm-hmm. I don't necessarily remember weaning. So it was a very natural...
It just happened. Yeah.
Yeah, and then there's great resources, like Dr. Catherine Detweiler talks about the normal age of human weaning, mm-hmm. and that's a great resource for people to look at to see why it's biologically normal.
Another question a lot of people had, and obviously these are personal questions, but it's obviously a highly personal topic. But people
right.
say, does it affect your intimacy, your
no.
personal life with your husband?
No, and I think it's so funny that people say that, especially about co-sleeping, you know,
mm-hmm.
and it's funny.
With the baby in the bed.
Yeah, yeah, right, and it's like, well, I mean, and this is a really personal thing to say, but, I mean, if that's the only place you're doing it, then I feel sorry for the people that are assuming that that's, you know, that's the only place that can happen. So not at all, and I think intimacy is extremely important mm-hmm. in a marriage, and I think a strong marriage is going to be a great foundation to show your children how to be raised confident and happy. And I had that with my family, mm-hmm. Too. So my parents were great role models for me, and that's why I'm confident in doing this.
No, it's an amazing story. And I have to say, it's courageous to put it on the cover, because you're right. You get a lot more hate.
A lot
than
more
you get
hate
like. I mean, there's no question about it. And
right.
I'm sure you knew that going in, as it sounds like you did. But.
Right.
You do certainly have the topic out there. So thanks so much
right.
to both of you. We appreciate it. And so nice to meet you.
Yeah, so nice to meet you. Thank you.
Thanks for having us.